What's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to show you how to live stream on YouTube using StreamYard. There are two ways to go live on YouTube. You could either go to YouTube directly or you could use a third-party software. The advantage of using third-party software like StreamYard is that you have more features and more flexibility, and that will allow you to do things you ordinarily would not be able to do if you are using just YouTube for your live stream. For instance, with StreamYard, you can have multiple guests, you can brand your live stream, you can share your screen with your viewers, you can highlight comments and notes that you want to emphasize, and a whole lot of other stuff. That is why using a software like StreamYard will make your YouTube live better than when you are using just the live feature on YouTube. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through how you can set up your YouTube live from StreamYard. To go live with StreamYard, first, you will need a StreamYard account. So you can click on the first link in the description below, and that link is going to bring you over to this page. You can just enter your email address and then click on Get Started. And if you use my link in the description, you see that you receive a $10 credit once you signed up. So go ahead and set up your StreamYard account. Once you are done with the setup, that should bring you over to your StreamYard account. I have an account here that I'm going to use. And the first thing you want to do is to come over to destinations. And here you can add the destinations you want to stream to. StreamYard gives you a lot of options. You can stream to multiple platforms at the same time. So you can link your Facebook page, Facebook group, LinkedIn page, LinkedIn profile, Facebook profile, YouTube channel, Twitter, and all of that. If you are streaming to YouTube, just click on YouTube channel, and it's going to walk you through the process of linking your YouTube channel to your StreamYard account. And once that is done, you are going to see all the destinations you've added. And then the next step is to come over to broadcast. Here you'll see the create button. You can just click on create. Now, if this is your first YouTube live, you need to request access to YouTube live on YouTube. So come over to YouTube, and then you can kind of click on this plus icon, then click on Go Live. Like I mentioned, if this is your first YouTube live, you are going to see this notification. You need to wait for 24 hours for YouTube to grant you streaming access. But if you've done any live on YouTube before now, you'll not have to deal with this. Just come back to your StreamYard account. And then after I click on create, you have three options: live stream, recording, on a webinar. Select live stream, and then you want to select the destination you are streaming to. So I'll select my YouTube channel here. Then you add the title of your live stream. I'm going to use how to set up YouTube live stream with StreamYard. Then you can enter your description as well. Then privacy, you can see that you have three options: public, unlisted, private. So I'm going to use unlisted for now. Then the next option is to schedule for later. If you are going live immediately, you can just skip this and click on create broadcast, and your live stream is going to start right away. Let's say I want to schedule this live stream. I'm going to check schedule for later, and then upload the thumbnail you want to use. Click apply. Then you select the day and the time you want to go live. Then click on create broadcast. Now you are going to see your scheduled broadcast right on this page. The next thing you need to do is to come over to YouTube, and let's open the live control room. Just click on this upload icon, click on go live. For these options, I'm going to select start at a later date, and then select streaming software. And here you are going to see the broadcast you just scheduled from StreamYard. So what you want to do here is to click on it. From here, you are going to see that auto start is enabled, but auto stop is disabled. What you want to do is to enable auto stop. And with this, anytime you end your live stream on StreamYard, it's going to end automatically on YouTube as well. Then you can also select the stream latency you want to use. By default, it's on low latency. With this option, viewers will be able to follow you close to real time, but the quality of your live stream is going to be quite low. If you use normal latency, the quality of your stream will be high, but then viewers are going to be like seconds behind you. Just choose the one that you prefer. Another thing you can do right here is to click on edit, and then you'll be able to edit the title if you want, the description. You can edit the schedule as well, the visibility. The reason why I have my visibility unlisted is because I'm not going live with this. But the proper thing to do is to make it public so that anybody on YouTube can find your live stream. Then scroll down, select the appropriate category. Here you have your thumbnail. You can add your live stream to a playlist if you have different playlists. You can do all of this other stuff just like you see when you are uploading videos normally on YouTube. Then you can add tags as well, stream language, recording date. for your comments. You can allow a comment and do all of that. Then you can also switch to customization. Here you can either turn on or turn off live chat. Then who do you want to participate in the chat? Then message delay, you can set that here. You know, you can add a trailer and all this other stuff. Then if your channel is monetized, you can come over to monetization and then turn on monetization for your live stream. And once you are done with all of this, you can just click on save. And with this, you are basically ready to go live. Once it's time to go live, you can just come over to StreamYard and then click on enter studio, enter the display name you want to use. This is the name viewers are going to see. You can click on settings. Right here, you can select the camera you want to use, the resolution. For audio as well, you can select the microphone you want to use, the speaker you want to use. Check echo cancellation and automatically adjust mic volume if you want your audio to be better. And if you want to use virtual background recording, you can do all of those stuff very, very easily. Then once you are done, click on enter studio. You have these different layouts you can present your live stream with. Also, if you want to share your screen, you can just click on present, share slides, share extra camera video file, or share the entirety of your screen. That's up to you. Then if you want to invite guests to join you in your live stream, you can just click on invite, then copy this link and share with them. There are a lot of other cool things you can do on your live stream. For instance, can come over to brand, set a brand color, theme, and all this other stuff. You could add your logo, set a custom background. All these things are very easy to figure out. But basically, once you are ready to start streaming, you can just click on go live and you'll be live on YouTube. And that's it, guys. If this video was helpful to you, please hit the like button and also be sure to subscribe and turn on the bell notifications so I get to know whenever I upload a video like this in the future. Thanks for watching till the end. I'll see you guys in the next one.